So what's going on, guys? Welcome to Tech Kura, and the Galaxy Z Fold 2 Lite key specs are already here, so I'll be sharing the details right after this. As the Galaxy Z Fold 2 has been released, so now the Galaxy Z Fold 3, Z Fold S and Z Fold Lite are already in the works. The Galaxy Z Fold 2 Lite is set to feature a 7.2 inch Super AMOLED display that bends in half due to a layer of ultra thin glass. The phone will be powered by Exynos 9825, which we have already seen in the Samsung's 2019 flagships. Although it has a front display, it will be small and narrow, which is specially made for notification, but that's not the most of the people want. However, the popular flex mode debuted from Galaxy Z Flip is likely to continue in all upcoming Samsung's foldable smartphones, so the Galaxy Fold 2 Lite will have this feature as well. According to report, the phone is expected to run One UI 2.5 based on Android 10 out of the box, and the hinge would likely be the same as the Galaxy Z Fold 2. Well, this spec seems to point towards a highly capable device, so it's obvious to have a highly debating price tag. The earlier report back in June indicated the Galaxy Z Fold 2 Lite may start as low as $900, but according to Sam Mobile, it will cost around $1,600 at least in India, but it could be slightly different from one country to another. As I mentioned at the beginning, the Galaxy Z Fold S is also in the work, and according to Sam Mobile, the phone is a Surface Duo-like foldable phone which will release in 2021. As per a newly emerged industry rumor, the Galaxy Z Fold S could feature a 360-degree hinge that means it will allow its display to fold both inward and outward. Another news we got today is the Galaxy S21 and S21 Plus battery capacities are now confirmed. China's telecom authority just certified a pair of batteries believed to belong to the Galaxy S21 and S21 Plus, identified as these model numbers. So according to certification, the Galaxy S21 will be powered by 3880 mAh battery, which suggests a typical capacity of 4000 mAh, which means the Galaxy S21 will likely offer no upgrade in terms of battery over the Galaxy S20, whereas the Galaxy S21 Plus will have a noticeable upgrade since it's now twice confirmed that it will feature 4660 mAh rating, which gives a typical battery capacity to 4800 mAh battery. On the other hand, the Galaxy S21 battery capacity has not leaked yet, but according to Leakster Ice Universe, it will not feature inbuilt as pain. It's all because of the big space necessary for bigger battery, but they can fit it if they make it slightly thicker, but I don't think they will since the Note 20 Ultra is already thick enough. In any case, now it's confirmed that we'll see the S Pen in S21 Ultra. So that's it for today, guys. Let me know your thoughts about these smartphones in the comments. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.